A unanimous vote being necessary to carry, if any be opposed to the resolution on independence, as proposed by the colony of Virginia, signify by...
Mr. President.
Oh, for heaven's sake, let me get through it once.
Mr. President. I move for a postponement.
Postponement? Huh. I wish you the same luck I had with it.
Mr. Adams is right. We need a postponement.
On what grounds?
On what grounds?
Mr. President, how can this Congress vote on independence without a written declaration of some sort defining it?
Well, what sort of declaration?
Ah, well, you know, listing the reasons for the separation, our purposes, goals, so forth, so on.
Ditto,
etc., etc.
We know those, don't we?
Oh, well, yes, good God, we know them. But what about the rest of the world? Certainly, we require the assistance of a powerful nation such as France or Spain. And such a written declaration would be consistent with European delicacy.
Come now, Mr. Adams. You'll have to do better than that. Answer straight. What would be its purpose?
Yes. Well...
To place before mankind the common sense of the subject in terms so plain and firm as to command their assent.
Mr. Jefferson, are you seriously suggesting that we publish a paper declaring to all the world that an illegal rebellion is in reality a legal one?
Oh, Mr. Dickinson, I'm surprised at you. You should know that rebellion is always legal in the first person, such as our rebellion. It is only in the third person, their rebellion, that it is illegal. Mr. President, I second the motion to postpone the vote on independence for a period of time sufficient for the writing of a declaration.
It has been moved and seconded. Mr. Thompson.
All those in favor of the motion to postpone signify by saying yay.
Yay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six colonies say yay. Against?
Nay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six colonies say nay.
Mr. Secretary, New York abstains, courteously.
Mr. Morris.
What in hell goes on in New York?
I'm sorry, Mr. President, but the simple fact is that our legislature has never sent us explicit instructions on anything.
Never. That's impossible.
Mr. President, have you ever been present at a meeting of the New York legislature? They speak very fast and very loud, and nobody listens to anybody else, with the result that nothing ever gets done. I beg the Congress's pardon.
My sympathies, Mr. Morris.
The vote again being tied, the chair decides in favor of postponement. So rule. A committee will now be formed to manage the declaration. Said document to be written, debated, approved by the beginning of July, some 3 weeks hence. At which time, Virginia's resolution on independence will finally be voted. Is that clear? Yeah. Very well. Will the following gentlemen serve on the declaration committee? Dr. Franklin.
Gladly.
Mr. John Adams.
Yes.
Mr. Sherman. Mr. Livingston.
Right.
Oh, and of course, Mr. Lee.
Excuse me, but I must be returning to the sovereign colony of Virginia, as I have been asked to serve as governor. Therefore, I must decline. A respectful Lee.
Very well, Mr. Lee, you're excused. I suppose we could leave it a four-man committee.
Just a moment. This business needs a Virginian. Therefore, I propose a replacement, Mr. Thomas Jefferson.
No, Mr. Adams.
Very well, Mr. Adams. Mr. Jefferson will serve.
I'm going home, too, to my wife.
Move to adjourn.
Wait.
I second.
Oh, Mr. Hancock. I haven't seen her for 6 months.
Moved and seconded. Any objections?
I have objections. I have lots of objections.
Go on, Congress, stand again.
Oh, John, I need to see my wife.
Come along, come along.
No,
come along, come
I'm on. Going home tonight.
Of course you are, of course. McNair, some rum up to my office. Oh, don't worry, Tom. Over here. I'll get at him, Mr. Rice.
I don't know. He had a funny look on his face.
He always does.
All right, gentlemen. Let's get on with it. Which of us will write our Declaration of Independence?